So, Liz, we're here with some lovely papyrus font close-ups on the many units of Fire Emblem. I was just thinking for a special feature, we just watch this.
Just watch the whole papyrus font.
Just watch the whole feature, and I wouldn't have to do the next chapter, which is probably going to be pretty hard, and I'll probably die a lot. And instead, we could just watch some archers. Look at this talented guy.
I mean,
look it.
He's nice, but he only has one resistance.
Yeah, well.
And there's a lot of papyrus here.
Yeah, no, it's pretty
I'm kind of concerned about the papyrus.
Okay, we'll play the game. We'll play the actual video game that we're going to play.
What's happening today in the world of Fire Emblem?
Play prison. You know, I just realized that's kind of funny because Jared is a lance unit.
Oh, yeah.
So that's about as narcissistic as you get.
He just named it after his weapon.
Yeah.
He hasn't named other things after his weapon.
Okay. On that note.
Yep.
On that note.
Oh, yeah. Hi there.
We get some random characters.
Yep.
Unimportant characters.
Sorry, the audience voted that you can't use Amy.
I would actually, you know, if she was a unit, I would absolutely use her.
No, I actually agree. That would be kind of fun. Oh, hey there.
Some mysterious cloaked figures. I think we're going to try to do cutscenes if we can, but we might have to skip them, so we'll see if this, if this works.
I feel like for whatever reason, it's specifically, like, the second or third cutscene that it sometimes tries and fails to load.
Oh.
So hey, this one doesn't have enough cutscenes to cut us off.
For now.
For now. Oh my god.
His first herb dealer.
Yeah. Oh hey.
So these are just some prisoners. Some really unimportant, not plot-relevant prisoners.
What an innocuous, friendly face.
Yes.
Don't worry about them. Mm-hmm. Oh, hey.
Local dad
friends.
Has arrived. Local... Well, one of the four people coming to rescue is actually competent. So that's a good start.
Ooh. Oh, my. A Banyan soldier who would help Laura.
Who we may or may not be looking at recruiting.
Interesting.
Depending on whether or not I can actually use him.
Yeah, you're just gonna have to find out who you can use here.
Yeah.
I like how Sov just steals things. Well, thank you.
Yeah, that boy, he'd be useless in a battle.
Yeah, can't have him battling.
So I will request, so we've got Ilyana here as a possible unit, and we'll have someone else coming in over from this entrance later in the battle. Am I allowed to know, because it's going to affect my deployment of characters, depending on whether or not I can use this unknown.
You will be adding exactly one more character to your roster to keep you through a little while here.
Yes.
That person is Ilyana.
Well, you know, I mean, she could try the front lines.
I
don't know how long she'd last out there, but you know, we could give it a real shot?
Yeah,
we just see what we can see out there.
You're just not getting a frontliner for a while, my friend.
Well, you know, when she promotes, she can use swords, so.
Is that true?
No!
Okay, I didn't think so.
Oh no, I'm lying through my teeth to ignore the pain.
Just checking.
Oh, jeez.
Just so we all know, Ilyana was actually the number one character coming in with 8 votes from various people. So, thank you, 8 of you, who said, yet again, what's a frontliner? Do we care?
I mean, some of us care. I might care. I might care a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If there are more characters you will be able to have before the end of the literal entire first fourth of the game.
But promised me somebody could use a sword.
Yes, at some point.
You said... Someone could use a sword.
There will be a character in this game who you can use that has a sword.
One character.
I promise.
Well, okay. In this game or in this part? Because I already know in this game there's a character that can use a sword.
Well, to be fair, I'm not necessarily counting this until right up until time to determine it.
Oh, jeez.
Let me think about this. I think one of these people can use a sword.
Yeah, it's not a resounding vote of confidence, really.
I mean, there are some people who could definitely be considered frontliners, if that makes it better.
No, that's good.
Yeah.
I just had a steel sword that I took off a man's body that I really wanted to
Yeah, I understand that.
You know.
So, this map. Victory is escape. Is there a specific escape spot you need to hit up?
Yes, there is. It's way down here.
Oh, goody. Through the entire field of soldiers.
Yeah, this one's a tricky one. One thing that I'm not gonna do, which I've done in the past, which has been fun, is split up. I've definitely tried to split up groups and succeeded in splitting up groups. It's much more difficult. We're gonna try to stick together and see what we can do.
Okay.
Yeah, Laura's, army friend comes in from over here. We might just murder him. I'm not too sympathetic to his plight if I can't put him to use.
Yeah,
I already have a lot of meat shields.
He's unfortunately not going to be of any use to you.
He comes in, I think, a little bit low level to be,
To be useful to you.
To be too useful as a meat shield, and I think I've already got enough to, like, kind of check that box.
Yep.
So...
Okay. So, with these allies here, is their job just to stay away and... not die, hopefully?
Yeah, hopefully.
Yeah.
They're a little tricky. You can command them to do certain things, which...
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, boy.
I'll try to do.
Okay. Are they a lose condition?
I'm positive. Yeah.
Any ally?
Yeah, they count. They're kind of... They're a little bit important to the plot.
No, I don't think they are. They're just random people.
You know, you'd be surprised, but they super are.
Oh.
Whoa. Okay.
Someone's moving up in the world.
Yeah, look at that.
Oh my god. It's beautiful.
I'm sure at some point I can just let people die. One of these days...
Oh, man. So that means if you gain your new ally, you have to make sure he survives too, huh?
Yeah, well, oh, that's a good reason not to, right?
Yeah.
Not to pick him up. Man, fuck. I mean, darn. Liliana, whoa, she's level 12.
Yeah, no, she actually comes in really buff. I love her.
Yeah. She's,
You should all get used to hearing me say that about pretty much every girl who joins the army.
Yeah. Ilyana's big fallback in this game, she's around a path of radiance, and this game, obviously. Her big... Oh, man.
Good job!
Her big fallback is that she has trouble doubling people, which is for a couple reasons. It's partially because her strength... Well, decent, you know, isn't amazing. It's also because Thunder Tomes are, like, heaviest, and her speed isn't great either, relatively, like...
So she needs to get a lot more speed and or a lot more strength.
Because if you don't have a high enough strength, then you get...
You get penalties. Yeah.
So, that's her big problem. She's actually a pretty good unit. A lot of people don't like using her much in this game, especially in comparison to the last game, where she was just... frankly terrifying because of that speed penalty and because she doesn't double as much. She can be trained up to be a good unit. I've taken her to the final battles before and she's been fine.
Mm-hmm.
She is a little bit tricky as a fighter at this stage, but I think I could use her.
Okay.
Wow. The unfortunate thing about meat shields that can't attack is that you can't level them up, and they definitely become increasingly less effective as meat shields.
Yeah.
So, Mr. Anime Protagonist down here, spot the difference, is... Wow, he's got green hair, too.
He's got bright green hair!
He also has a javelin, but...
He's not gonna kill Kaya. So, are we aiming to break down the gate at the bottom right here? Is that the plan?
Down here?
Yeah, right here.
Yeah, we can get into it with a couple characters. It's going to be tricky to navigate these archers in here. They can do a lot of damage with the steel bows.
Well, knowing you, you'll trap at least one of them.
Yeah, well, we'll see. We'll see how my advanced shove techniques. And then, this really unfortunate man will probably ride over and start attacking people. I like coming in from this side with this group a little bit better, because I think that, it'll be a little bit less chaotic. And
yeah.
It'll be easier to lure these units without triggering Burton's attack range. He's got a wind edge, too, which means that he's able to attack.
He's got two spaces of range,
He's got two spaces
right?
of range. Also, he's got a skill that discipline is a skill that can be equipped. He's not going to drop it, but I could steal it from him.
Oh, that's
So that's something
worth.
To keep in mind.
That's worth grabbing if you can.
Yeah. So those skills, like Leo's cancel that I mentioned a while back, can be applied once we get to the point. Eventually we'll get to a point where we can have a home base menu and do things with that. At this point we still can't, but someday.
Okay.
So I think if I talk to him, then he can then become the meat shield that he wants to see in the world, and then this guy won't be able to get him.
That sounds pretty good. Guy. Okay. I like that. Hey.
Blah, 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 blah. Friendship is good. Bad guys are bad.
Hey, he's on our side.
Yeah, that's what I like to see.
Do we want to trade away
oh,
weapons?
Oh, yeah. We'll get to that.
Alright. Well, that was a really exciting set of turns.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, man. Look at
and
that.
And I was all worried that they would be doubling him.
No crit chance, 75 hit chance. Oh, beautiful, Leo.
That's what I like to see. Oh, okay. Well,
Leo.
That kind of took some of the steam out of it.
He had 95, right?
Yeah, he did.
Oh, my God.
Oh, well. How it goes.
I guess sometimes, yeah, critical fail.
Yeah.
It was the 5%.
Well,
all right.
These guys can't kill. I think these guys have the same. Oh, this guy has one more strength. Oh, that was
That's
a totally different guy.
Yeah.
11. So I don't think, I think Micaiah could... Oh, nope, that killed her.
Oh, yep, okay. That's also scary.
It's not gonna kill her, though.
Yeah, as long as she hits.
Right, she doesn't have a great hit rate. You know what? I think that, yep, we're just gonna do that. You know, we could be done with this, Leo, if you hadn't missed on your
95% hit chance.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Well, Ilyana's hit rate is also a point of complaint, which, no, I understand.
Yeah. Isn't that another, like, not only just, like, how she works, but I think it's Thunder Magic, too.
Yes. Thunder Magic is kind of the axes of magic, which is a weird statement, but,
No, it makes sense. Big damage, less chance to do it.
Right. There's axes, lances, and swords. Axes do the most damage, have the least chance to hit. Swords do the least damage, have the most chance to hit, and lances are somewhere in between.
Yep. So, yeah. The thunder.
I don't think that guy's gonna... Oh, no, he's gonna run away.
Okay. Okay. Well, got some new friends here.
That's alright. Yeah.
So we'll just block
yep,
that archer.
That's the plan.
Great.
You know what? You said you thought I was gonna trap one of them, and I wanted to live up to your ideas.
I'm
to your ideals.
I'm really glad that we could make that happen.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
miss.
Yeah, I hope you get someone who can use axes.
Now he doesn't have range.
That's true, I like it.
Also, I caught that. I hope that I get someone who can use axes too.
real talk for just like half a second. I cannot remember what... Is it axes that Jill uses in this game?
Yes. Yes, okay. The mounted wyvern knights, or dragon knights, draco knights, whatever they're called, in Path of Radiance use lances, and in Radiant Dawn use axes. Okay. So, I really hope that I get somebody who can use axes. Oh god, look at this. Just making a mockery of this guy.
I am loving the steel ball.
Oh my...
Double cancel?
Well, the second one didn't matter, but I think this is a miraculous occasion, everyone. This is the first time that cancel's actually triggered in a way that's useful.
Oh my god.
Cancel actually was useful there.
Good job,
that's
Leo.
What you're supposed to use it for. I'm kind of in awe right now.
Useful cancel 2K17.
Yeah. This really is the year of possibilities.
One of my big questions for this run of Radiant Dawn is whether any single level will make you reset more than that one level
than
chapter
the first one.
Yeah.
Probably. There's definitely some tricky ones. It's also going to be difficult because just the way that... that this game is structured, there's a bunch of different sections, and of course, at, like, each new section of the game, in a lot of cases, you get an entirely new cast, or a somewhat new cast. So, you know, I'll train these guys all up to the point that they're really great and awesome, and I don't need to worry about them.
And
they get crits,
them.
And they're amazing, and then they leave for, like, hours and hours and hours of gameplay,
right,
and I get a bunch of new babies.
Train up a whole new set of
Yeah.
That is going to be something you'll have to reckon with, I guess.
Yeah. So that's, I mean, yes, there definitely will be levels where I have to reset a bunch of times in the future. If only just because of that, but also because there's some really obnoxious levels that exist in this game, so... I'm going to bring these guys down here because I believe you can get some bonus XP from hitting them through the escape.
Oh, nice.
Just for anybody who doesn't know, bonus XP you can apply at that base area to get level ups.
Once we have access to that menu, we can just kind of dump it on characters to level them up quickly.
It's very particularly useful... Beyond just, you know, getting quick levels, which can be useful because there's some scripted level-ups that happen late in the game, so bonus XP can be really useful. Bonus XP is a godsend for one other reason, which is that you can use it to get ridiculously powerful units, such as my favorite max stats, Makaya, as I like to call her, which I think I've gotten every run for ever,
You're
pretty
on
much.
Certainly a streak.
At least three or four that I've had in a row, because... there's a whole complex mechanic to it that I'll probably explain once we get to it.
Yeah, we'll
right
talk
now
about
I'm
going
to focus
time.
On trying to deal with these guys.
The point is, we want a lot of bonus XP if we can, because the more bonus XP, the more we can manipulate stats into being awesome.
Yes. I do need to be careful of that longbow, as you said. It's a longbow, which means that he has range not just out to here, but out to... Here?
Three spaces,
yeah,
which is just
this whole. And annoyingly, I can't select that range, because of course that chooses a huge range, so... It'll be interesting.
Yep.
I've got ideas for how to deal with it. Which we'll get to when we get to. Mm-hmm. But it is something to try to be aware of.
Oh, bless you, Leo.
Mm-hmm. He hit that doubling confidence point, and
He's
never
just
looked
been
back.
Soaring since, yeah. Absolutely.
No,
oh my
soaring
God.
Doesn't come into later.
Oh, okay.
Now, I think what we want to do to pull this off... Actually, I think Makaya can just go in and kill this guy, but then she'll be in range of the longbow.
Right.
And I'm not super confident about how much damage he might do. But I think what I might do is a little sweep in, have her attack, and then pick her up, have somebody use the rescue command. Not quite as fancy and impressive as a shove, but... You know, if you use... Oh my god, really?
Wow.
Okay,
Maybe just because you're taking so long?
No, I think it's probably because we're getting close, but okay. I'm still going to do what I was going to do, which is this, and then pick her up.
Yeah, okay.
Boink. Actually, I could possibly have somebody go in and kill the longbow. I wonder if you can kill the longbow guy.
It's enough damage,
he can soft and just go in and, like,
lock that up.
Hang out here. Yeah.
Okay, sure. If we're lucky, he'll even get a cancel.
Hey!
Good job, Leo! Mm-hmm. Oh man, he's caught up to where Eliana started, too.
Yeah.
And still is.
Yeah, Eliana hasn't leveled yet.
Oh wow, okay, all three of your attacking characters are level 12 right now. That's
and
actually really
level four.
Awesome. And level 4.
He's working on it.
We're working on it. Boink.
The boink's not totally the sound effect I would have.
I like it though, because it just. Here's the thing about Fani, is it just completely annihilates them.
Uh-huh. Which, again, boink is not what comes to mind.
That's kind of the joke.
Okay. Yeah. I'm just saying that it's not totally...
Yeah. I'll accept that.
Yeah.
Bye, Edward.
He's out of here.
He's gone. Nolan, too? Alright.
Yeah. Take a hike, Dad.
Okay.
We'll keep Laura around just in case there's anybody to heal up.
Yep.
Hey!
Oh, no!
Oh, fuck!
Oh, God.
Oh, thank God. Okay. I hope he made Tari to them. He ran right up. Oh,
God. No.
Oh,
wait.
Oh, right.
Right.
He's a
this
beefy
is
boy.
We're talking about. Kurt
Holy
has...
shit! I didn't realize he had that much HP.
That's so funny.
Oh, talk about overkill.
We mentioned he's plot important, but don't worry, he doesn't fight.
He's just a normal, everyday merchant boy.
He's not much of a fighter. He said so himself, and we believe him, right?
Yes. Why does he have so much HP?
Oh my God, that is ungodly.
That is the most overkill, and he barely took any damage, too.
That's so funny, oh my God.
I was so nervous.
I know.
I was so nervous. I was sitting here like, I got through this entire thing.
You were like, oh good, the ranged character didn't attack him, and I was like, I don't know.
Yeah, but oh man.
Instead we're just,
well, you know,
oh man,
healing back up all that damage he took. That's so unnecessary.
Wow.
That pilgrim class is really OP.
They just really don't want you to kill that
nerf
pilgrim.
Nerf pilgrim, please.
No, I think they don't have to nerf it. It's fine.
Nerf pilgrim.
Oh, man. Later.
Nerf pilgrim.
55 HP.
And that, my friends, is how you win chapter.
28 turns later.
See you later, suckos. Enjoy your shitty tool prison. Yeah, everything sucks
here. We know. Benyon sucks.
Dayan used to suck, and now Benyon sucks, and, you know.
At least there's
sucks.
These hot merchants to keep us alive.
Yeah. I mean, they're basically saying that Benyon sucks and it sucks for Dayan. And maybe there's something better out there.
King Ashnard left an orphan behind.
Certainly not. King Ashnard was the big head honcho dick in Dayan. And he was the king. Obviously, his name is King Ashnard. You kind of got to kill him at the end of Path of Radiance. So...
He's very dead now.
Yes. You said that like he's not... He is very dead now.
Yeah, no, he is.
Okay.
I'm just saying he's very dead
now.
Yes.
Okay, yeah. You said it kind of like he wasn't dead.
No, no.
But he is actually very dead.
Yes.
But maybe his kid isn't, so they're gonna go on a quest to find his orphan child.
I mean, if there is such a kid, let's just hope he's really not like his dad, personally. But... Alright.
Alright, so...
Chapter 3.
Look at that reset counter. I can't help but notice that it's still at 11.
Well done.
Oh.
Well done.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You just completely creamed that one.
I kind of did. So thank you very much, everyone. Next time we'll see what awaits us in Desert Orphanland.
Desert Orphanland.
And I would like to personally give a shout out to everyone who didn't give me a frontline. It just makes me look cooler. Very genuinely, thank you. It just makes me look cooler.
We'll just have to come back next time and see you be cool some more.
Mm-hmm. As long as nobody attacks my units, I'm fine.
Solid.